Today's lab is about isolation of bacteria in pure form. Now, to perform isolation of bacteria in pure form, we have to prepare our culture media. First of all, we have the enrichment culture media, which is called blood agar. As you see, it is solid, poured into sterile disposable petri dishes. And it is called enriched because we supplement the culture media with extra blood. So both gram positive, gram negative, and yeast will grow and isolated using blood agar culture. Now, the second culture media, it is called McConkie agar, as you see. And these plates of McConkie are used for the isolation mainly of gram negative bacteria. The third type of culture media is CLET culture media. As you see, its color is green, and it is used to isolate some of the gram-positive and some of the gram-negative microorganisms. Now, we have also two types of selective culture media, hecton-enteric agar, green-colored culture media, and it is used to isolate Salmonella and Shigella. And the alternative of the hecton-enteric agar is SS agar, and it is used also to isolate Salmonella and Shigella, enteric bacilli. Now, we bring our cotton and Dettol disinfectant, and we disinfect the area where we are going to isolate or to make the street plate visible. As you see, we flame the Bunsen burner and bring our bacteriological loop. Now, this bacteriological loop, it is the microbiological tool which is used in microbiology lab. As you use the pencil or the pen to write your notes in microbiology lab, all the time you work using the bacteriological loop. Now, this loop is a standard. The circle of the loop, this circle, is either 1 over 100 microliter or 1 over 1000 microliter or 1 over 500 microliter capacity. Now we flame our loop, as you see, to sterilize the metal part of the loop, which is used to transfer the colony from media to media, which is called culture media, subculture, or inoculation from fluid or the sample into culture media. After flaming the loop, when it becomes red, it means it is ready for use. Now, suppose we have a sample like Staphylococcus. This is Staph aureus, Staphylococcus, on CLED agar media. And we want to make what is called subculture into another clean media. For example, we take CLED agar, we take one of these separated round colonies from the CLED culture media containing the staphylococci. First of all, we transfer the colony on the third part of the plate, and we do what is called streaks, which means straight lines. Then we turn our plate 90 degrees and we flame the loop again, and we cool the tip of the loop aside, and then we take from these streaks some of the sample and do another 4 to 5 streaks. Then we turn the plate again and we flame the loop, then cool it inside the plate, and we take from the second streak and make another 4 to 5 streaks, and the last streak is without flame. Now, as you see, here we spread our sample or colony, and then clockwise we are doing what is called dilution. The number of colonies clockwise will decrease till we get separated colonies, as you see in this plate. Now, after incubation, 24-hour incubation, as you see here, we have heavy growth for the colonies. Then, when you move clockwise, you will see that the colonies will get separated from each other till you get separate colonies. Now, this is very important, the dilution of colony. It is very important to study the colony characters. For example, Staphylococcus aureus, it will ferment the clade constituents and it will form yellow-golden colonies on clade culture media. So this is a character for Staphylococcus aureus. For example, here we have another type of microorganism. We have Pseudomonas aeruginosa. You can look to this plate. Now in this area you have heavy growth. When you move clockwise, you will get separate colonies from each other with fruity smell. This is Pseudomonas aeruginosa on Miller-Hinton agar. As you see, it gives metallic sheen with separated colonies, and when you smell, you can recognize the apple rot-like smell. Another example, we have, for example, Escherichia coli. Escherichia coli turn the McConkey agar from this orange color into pink color because it is lactose fermenter. McConkey agar medium can differentiate between the lactose fermenter and the lactose non-fermenter because it contains lactose. As you see here, we have heavy growth, and then when you move clockwise, you will get separated colonies of Escherichia coli, which is pink in color. Now, we have another organism as an example also, which is Klebsiella, and look at the Klebsiella, how it looks like very mucoid, wet-like colonies with less ability to fermentation on McConkey than the Escherichia coli. Of course, the Escherichia coli, Klebsiella are separated from urine culture. Now, this is another Klebsiella isolate on blood agar. Look how it looks like mucoid, big colonies on the blood agar. We flame the loop all the time before and after use so that it will remain sterile and to prevent contamination between samples. Now, if we have a broth containing mixture of microorganisms or sample, clinical sample of the patient, we open the broth or the sample and take loop full from the suspension or the tube which contains bacteria. Then we close the tube and we are going to use here blood agar. You transfer the drop of suspension and start doing again the streak. This plate has a partition where you can subculture two samples if you want. Now we flame our loop. You take from the first streak, do another streak, and you can separate the rest of the colonies on the second partition of the plate. Now, after you finish subculture or inoculation of the sample using the suitable culture media, either blood agar or McConkey or clade or other types of selective media, you mark your plate by putting a number, like for example 400, for example, over 6 over 2012. This means this is the sample number 400 in the month in June in the year 2012. And this is very important for recording. In research labs, we just put the number of the sample which we subculture, for example 15. This is the number which is recorded for research purposes. Now, so labeling of the plate is done by the marking pen water resistant, and it is important to put either a patient name or patient number, or the serial number which is used in the lab for recording and for research purposes. After that, the inverted plates are placed inside the incubator. Now, this is our incubator, as you see. The temperature of the incubator is 37, and we open the incubator and put our plates inverted. All the time should be closed and check for the incubator temperature from time to time. Now the incubation period is 24 hour incubation for the bacteria if it is aerobic, and if it is anaerobic we bring what is called micro aerophilic jar, as you see, and we put the inoculated plates this way, and we bring candle is lightened, suppose it is lighted, and put it inside the micro aerophilic jar. We close the micro aerophilic jar on the plates. Now in this system the candle, it will utilize some of the oxygen in the area inside the micro aerophilic jar, and we put it inside the incubator like this. Now this is used in case of the isolation of throat swab, because streptococci and other bacteria which are micro aerophilic, which needs some of the carbon dioxide, is used, so we use the micro aerophilic condition. Now if we want totally anaerobic condition, we use what is called gas generating kit. And gas generating kit, we bring one of these envelopes. This is the gas generating kit. As you see, we open it and place it inside with a few of water, and we place it inside the anaerobic jar to make all the atmosphere inside the anaerobic jar totally anaerobic by producing a lot of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Thank you.